In today's episode, I'm going to quickly demo how to use ActionMailer preview to kind of make this kind of thing. And we're going to use FactoryBot to kind of set up some mock data for it. Making mailers in Rails is quite fun. It comes with a lot of tools out the box to kind of make it a lot easier and to like catch your back. There's a few little tricks you should probably know about to kind of save you a bunch of time. So obviously you can add tests to make sure something has the content. You can add letter opener. And that's where, when your app sends a email in your development environment, it will capture it and show it to you. But Rails also ships with a way to preview emails, and this is where you pass in some data, and it will just show you what that email will look like. Let's jump into that. To kind of see what previews you have already within your app, once you turn it on, go to Rails slash mailers. If it's a blank screen, don't worry. That means you just haven't made any yet. So, where are they actually stored? If you're using RSpec, they'll be in spec slash mailers slash previews. That's where they're all going to live. If you're doing mini tests or something, it'll be in tash slash mailers slash previews. So, very similar. But you can also override where they live just by changing this config, which some apps may do. Let's go ahead and make one. So, I'm going to add one, and I'm going to call it user mailer preview. Gonna stick it there, and so we're gonna call it user mailer preview, and we're gonna inherit from the action mailer preview base. Let's quickly restart Rails and see what that does. Okay, we can see it's picked up on something, so it's found it. So if we would maybe add a quick method in, let's say hello world, what does that do? Oh, it comes up. So if we click it, nothing really happens in this one. So let's actually like go to one of our mailers and put that in there. I'm going to call it user welcome notification because we're emailing the user and it's a welcome message and it's a notification as well. And yeah, I think what we need to do there, we just call it like we would within the app, and we want to do user.last. That will pull the last user out of the database and just show it. Okay, we can see that here. There we go. That looks pretty good. We can switch between the text view and the HTML view. So that's really nice. So if you wanted to tweak that, that'd be perfect. We could probably tidy this up as well. I have a really cool trick I want to show you. What I normally do is I make a method called like user, and I'll be like user.last. This way, if I make like lots of mailers, I can just use the same user for all of them. So that's pretty cool. But I've recently found this really cool new trick where I could do FactoryBot.build and I could just build a user. This is really cool because it means that I'm going to get like a piece of randomized-ish information because I've got factory user. In my factories, I use Faker, so it's going to be random each time. You can see the email changing up here, and it means I get a bit of variation, and I'm not using my actual database data for it. So that's all there is to this tutorial. Action mailer previews are so good. I find them so like so nice, and this little factory bot trick has completely changed the way I want to write them. Please remember to smash that like button if you enjoyed this, and leave a comment for if there's anything you're interested in. I will see you next time, and thank you for watching.